The area around the small inlet and beach beside the Arcadia Cafe has attracted bathers since time immemorial and developed into a place for relaxation and pleasure. Many changes took place through the years from the Victorian era up to the present day. These include the building of cafes, ballrooms, bathing boxes, swimming and paddling pools, a Lido development, and entertainments such as perro shows, church missions, street theatre, concerts and variety shows, to name but a few. Men's bathing had become common throughout the Victorian era, and in the 1880s the beach area beside the Arcadia was set aside for ladies only. The area was strictly controlled, and the women wore full-body bathing suits as befitting of the period. Early bathing machines and bathing boxes were provided to the rear of the large rocks, which once stood on the site of the Arcadia Cafe, and the early Arcadia Cafe buildings all included changing facilities to the rear, with steps leading down into the water to protect the ladies' modesty. Old photographs clearly show small crowds of gentlemen standing at the perimeter fences, admiring the view. Local entrepreneurs set up stalls providing all the necessities for a day at the beach: deck chairs, refreshments, bathing suits and towels. And these soon developed into a larger shop, then the addition of a cafe, later further extension to provide a place for tea dances, and finally the construction of the widely known and loved Arcadia Ballroom. During the 1970s, rock, pop and punk bands all played the Arcadia, but changing holiday tastes and new attractions saw the demise of the ballroom and its conversion into an amusement arcade and snooker hall before being demolished during the 1990s. From its opening in 1953, the Arcadia Ballroom became well known throughout the British Isles. Developed by Bert Blundell, an entrepreneur from England, the Arcadia Ballroom rapidly became the place for dancing, and crowds came from far and wide across Ireland and beyond. The Dave Glover Showband was resident from 1953 to 1960, and thereafter the venue hosted many famous Irish showbands and renowned dance bands, such as Joe Loss and his orchestra. Concerts by military bands in the 1960s and early 1970s, together with entertainments such as the finals of the ever-popular Miss Portrush, Miss Elegance and talent competitions, added to the appeal of the Arcadia. As a reminder of those halcyon days of the 1950s, sit back and listen to a recording of Dave Glover playing one of his best-known hits, Bueno Serra. Enjoy.
Thank you very much indeed. Give a next wee round of applause for my best friend, Jerry Rice. All I want is Tony and Trixie and all the boys, and I'd be delighted. It'd be great.
Buenos Aires, señorita, Buenos Aires. For it's time to say goodnight in Napoli. For it's hard for me to whisper Buenos Aires while that old moon's about the Mediterranean Sea. In the morning, signorina, we'll go walking when the mountains and the sun come into sight. By the little old jeweler's shop we'll stop and linger while I buy that wedding ring by your finger. In the meantime, let me tell you that I love you, babe. Buenos Aires, señorina, kiss me goodnight. Thank you. Senorita Bonazera. For it's time to say goodnight in Napoli, know the words. For it's hard for me to whisper Bonazera while that old moon's above the Mediterranean Sea. In the morning, Senorita, we go walking when the mountains and the sun come into sight. By the little old jeweler's shop, we'll stop by.